What's up, my friends? I missed you guys. I'm back, and so is my excessive hand talking. I'm sorry. I didn't want to stand you up. It just sort of happened. Overhyped or underhyped? Jack Eichel. I'm frustrated, and I'm not Jack Eichel. Did Jordan Binnington throw an absolute toddler-level tantrum?
Now he's gonna go over David Dubnyk. Here we go.
He did. He did. The way Erik Karlsson flinched. Why aren't we talking about that? Dude was scared. You can't faze me.
Do I look nervous?
Editor Jackie here. We have an update.
David Kampf, like who? Never heard of him. The North Division. Absolutely no defense being played. I can't believe people actually think that that's a real thing. Garbage take. I don't subscribe. What is this nonsense? Do I look nervous? I don't subscribe. What's up, my friends? I missed you guys. I'm sorry that I stood you up last week, but you know, life happens and things happen, and I just couldn't hack it last week. It's been, I do think that I owe you just a slight little apology. I'm sorry. I didn't want to stand you up. It just sort of happened. It's not you, it's me. It really was me. Life got crazy. My sister just had twins, two boys. They're fraternal, although they look exactly the same. Tanner and Taylor. I already have a favorite. TJ, Tanner would be my favorite because his middle name's Jack after me, so clearly I will cater to him more so than Taylor. Sorry about your luck, bud. Anyways, the point is I've missed doing this show. Can I call it a show? It's more of a segment. Either way, I hope you missed me just a little. The segment is back, I'm back, and so is my excessive hand talking. It's just who I am. I can't change now. Been around too long, but not that long. Topic number one. No way did Jordan Binnington throw an absolute toddler level tantrum.
Feistiness as he always does. Now he's gonna go over David Dubnyk. Here we go.
He did. And while some people didn't like it, I personally could not get enough of it. It was funny. It was entertaining. It was absolutely ridiculous and unnecessary. And to me, it's just 10 times funnier that it's coming from the same dude that once said in a media scrum, do I look nervous?
Do I look nervous? Do I look nervous?
You can't faze me.
Where's your answer?
I'm calm, cool, and collect. I'll work on my English. You can't faze me.
What's your answer?
I'm calm, cool, and collected. I'm Jordan Binnington. Nobody gets under my skin. Wrong. Incorrect. All it took was a 13-goal game for Jordan Binnington to snap. This was not a mature breakdown, down. I mean, it's the kind of thing where if you're on the ice, you can't really help but laugh, which probably only made Binnington even more mad. He just lost his cool and ran around the ice like a three-year-old saying, I'm not happy. And everybody needs to be unhappy with me. Oh, it's too good. I've watched it like 100 times. So I'll start by saying this. I have absolutely no problem with what Jordan Binnington did. Didn't hurt anybody. Maybe Karlsson's ego a little bit, because did you see that flinch?
Ben, something was said there and he went right over.
Let's start there. The way Erik Karlsson flinched at that fake punch is underhyped. Why aren't we talking about that? Dude was scared. Like, EK was afraid. He, for a split second, thought he was getting decked. And he ducked for cover. It was a pretty emphatic flinch. That's all I'm saying. Oh God, don't hit me. Please don't hit me. Ugh. The Erik Karlsson flinch is underhyped. Not getting enough talk, not getting enough attention. Hilarious. Now, as for Jordan Binnington, I had no problem with what he did. However, this idea that the Blues started and that fans have really taken on as a real thing. People are actually subscribing to this theory that Jordan Binnington running around the ice, fake punching people and talking trash, somehow sparked his team to victory that day is absolutely overhyped and, quite frankly, ridiculous. There were 13 freaking goals scored in that game. You think Jordan Binnington fake punching Erik Karlsson inspired his team? Give me a friggin' break. I can't believe people actually think that that's a real thing. Of course the Blues are gonna come out and say that. What else are they gonna say? They're probably embarrassed by association. Trying to fire up his team. I do not buy that for a minute. He fired up his team and that's why they won. That ain't it. Dos, number two. Let's go. I'm gonna say the Jack Eichel speculation is actually underhyped. When I think about Jack Eichel's career, I'm frustrated and I'm not Jack Eichel. There's been absolutely zero consistency. And I think we should be talking more about the absolute gong show that has been the Buffalo Sabres while Jack Eichel has been there. He's in his sixth season right now, hasn't even been in the league for 6 full years, and the guy's had 3 different coaches. 3! Dan Bylsma, Phil Housley, Ralph Krueger. 3 coaches in 5.5 seasons. But that's not enough inconsistency for the second overall pick. Let's also change our GM every 2 years, just for kicks. Yeah, this team's changed coaches over the last 6 years more times than I've changed my hair color, and I change my hair color all the time. You know, it's a real shock this team hasn't made the postseason with all this turnover and constant change. There has been zero consistency for the Buffalo Sabres since Jack Eichel arrived. In fact, Jack Eichel might be the most consistent piece of that puzzle to date. And then people wonder why the Sabres haven't made the playoffs since Jack Eichel arrived. Well, no shit. I don't want to hear these garbage takes about Jack Eichel's the problem and Jack Eichel can't lead and Jack Eichel's not a winner. We love to do this with these high-end draft picks, right? When the team doesn't have success, we like to blame those top-tier players, right? Oh, they're not leaders. They're not winners. They don't make the people around them better. Yeah, guess who else had that narrative for about a decade? Alex Ovechkin. Nobody's saying that now. Why is this a thing for Jack Eichel? It shouldn't be. Jack Eichel was lights out last year. What more do you want from the guy? The fans are frustrated, and I get it. Normally, I'm against trade requests, but in this case, I can actually see why Jack Eichel might want to just sneak out the back door. The situation around him has shown no signs of improving. So, to me, I think the story is probably getting the attention that it deserves, but I think this narrative that's coming out now about Jack Eichel potentially being the problem or not being a leader and blah, 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 that's overhyped. I have no time for that. That's a Mickey Mouse take. I hate that take. Anyone who says that they would not be frustrated if they were Jack Eichel is lying to you and they're lying to themselves. Hashtag next. Whew, I actually got like a little mad there. I need to calm down. The 3 spot, the North Division. Overhyped. I agree with you. I had so many people tweeting me and Instagramming me to talk about the North Division. Yes, it is pretty severely overhyped, especially north of the border. I'm not gonna name names, but someone did say to me that the North Division overshadows the rest of the league. It's so great, so fun to watch. The All-Canadian Division is fun to watch because there's absolutely no defense being played, save the Maple Leafs have been good. I still think the Leafs are one of the best teams in the league, and the idea that what they're doing is somehow less worthy of praise because of the division they play in, garbage take, underhyped, I don't subscribe. But the North Division is not the best division in the NHL. My vote would actually go to the Central Division. There's only 4 teams in the NHL with a points percentage over 700, and 2 of them play in the Central Division. Your defending Stanley Cup champion, Tampa Bay Lightning, who have been lights out since they dropped 2 of 3 to the Florida Panthers, who are also one of the 4 teams above a points percentage of 700.
Editor Jackie here. We have an update. It's now 5 teams with a points percentage over 700. And guess what? Three of them are in Central. Yeah, the Caniacs. They've joined the 700 party. What up?
Say what you want about the Panthers. You are what your record says you are. So you cannot take that away from them. And they've played more than like three games. So it's not a small sample size. It counts. So yeah, so you've got the Stanley Cup defending Bolts. You've got the Florida Panthers who appear to have taken another step this year. Then you've got the Carolina Hurricanes that nobody talks about, but everybody should. Do not sleep on the Hurricanes. Then you have the Chicago Blackhawks, who were supposed to be in the basement of the division. They weren't supposed to have even a sniff of the conversation in terms of playoffs, and yet here they are doing the damn thing. I mean, Kevin Lankinen is giving them incredible goaltending, super underhyped. You've got a team that is without Jonathan Toews, their number one center, but it doesn't end there. Kirby Dach, also a center. He's out. Dylan Strome on the sidelines day to day, so he'll be back. But my point is, how often do we talk about the importance of center depth? All the time. It's all any pundit wants to talk about. Center depth, center depth, center depth. Look at what the Blackhawks are doing right now without three of their centers. And even if you don't want to include Dylan Strome, what are their centers right now? Hold, please. Top line center is a rookie, Suter. A really good rookie, but a rookie no less. Carl Soderberg, Lucas Walmart, David Kampf, like who? Never heard of him. It's a joke. Settle down, Hawks fans. It is ridiculous what this team is doing. I love it. Patrick Kane is in the conversation for the Hart right now. Hands down, no questions asked. I look at that division, and with the exception of the Detroit Red Wings, the Central's a tough division. So the North division is overhyped. The Central division is underhyped. Here's what we're gonna do. Get in the comments, let me know which division you think is the easiest, which division you think is the toughest, and just for fun, which division you think is the most entertaining. Get at your girl. I'll see you in the comment section. We wanna do one more. Oh my gosh, I gotta go. Some odds and ends courtesy of you guys. Apparently Blue Jays games are not gonna be on the radio this year. What is this nonsense? This is an underhyped storyline. I had no idea and I hate it. My dad is a big time baseball on the radio guy, so that's kind of how I was raised. I played baseball and I sometimes watched it, but for the most part, my dad would have the game on the radio and he always said he felt closer to the game when he listened to it on the radio than he did watching it. I don't know why he subscribes to that theory. It's old school, but I'm really sad that Blue Jays games are not gonna be on the radio this year because that was a big part of my childhood. So it's sad that that's over. Kings and Wild retros, both of them are money. Send them my way. Two of the best in the league. It's not even up for debate. Bill Murray's Hawaiian shirt at the Golden Globes. The guy is an absolute legend. That's not news to anybody, but I love that he decided to rock the old guy on vacation Hawaiian tropical shirt at the Golden Globes. Mad respect to Bill Murray, per usual. This one sent from you guys too, leg day. Leg day is underhyped. I don't know why people don't like leg day. I do three of them a week. This is a new development, but still, as hard as it is, it's necessary for those gains. Last but not least, this topic comes to you courtesy of me. Is anybody watching The Boys right now? I just started it. It's about superheroes that aren't really super. They're actually kind of bad. I just started it. I'm only a few episodes in, but have you watched it? Do you liked it? Do you liked it? Have you watched it? Do you like it? Is it under or overhyped? From where I'm sitting, that show is underhyped because I haven't really heard anyone talk about it, and now I'm watching it and I'm like, what is this amazingness? Hit me up. And that is a wrap on this week's edition of Overhyped or Underhyped, also known as Episode 6, officially in the books. I hope you guys liked it. Get at me in the comments. Did you agree? Did you disagree? Am I out of my mind? Don't answer that. It's been a pleasure, as it always is. Thanks for all the love last week when the episode did not show up. It actually really meant a lot to me that people cared. So thanks for caring about this thing that I do. And I will do my best never to stand you up again. but it'll probably happen at some point. Anyways, you know I'm terrible at goodbyes, so we're just gonna end this thing. Bye.